Hi, I'm Pastor Goodman.
And this is the Largely Catechized Life.
All right, so shout out today to the Christians who maybe don't feel so much like soldiers that march, but the wounded that get carried. Shout out to the ones who pray their very best and hardest, but wrestle with the same stupidity and weakness and sin week after week after week. Shout out to the desperate and the lonely and the afflicted and the ones who feel for the life of them like they just do not fit. And by shout out, I mean communion, body and blood for you. A God who not only recognizes your weakness, your inability to fix these things, no matter how hard you try, your frustration, your fear, your unworthiness, your guilt, your shame, but the God who wants to do something about it, who wants to give you comfort, who promises, "Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest," and backs it up by bringing that rest in body and in blood. This is who the Lord's Supper is for. This is the great comfort that our Lord would pour out for you. Our Lord would give himself to you in body and blood to strengthen the weak ones, not so that the proud ones would joyfully parade around. In the Large Catechism, Luther writes, "If therefore you are heavy laden and feel your weakness, then go joyfully to this sacrament and obtain refreshment, consolation, and strength. For if you would wait until you are rid of such burdens that you might come to the sacrament pure and worthy, you must forever stay away. For in that case, he pronounces the sentence and says, 'If you are pure and godly, you have no need of me, and I, in turn, none of thee.' Therefore, those alone are called unworthy who neither feel their infirmities nor wish to be considered sinners." See, the Lord's Supper is only for sinners. Jesus is given only for sinners. He died only for those who could not live on their own. He died for you. And here he gives you body and blood for the forgiveness of all of your sins, for refreshment, for consolation, for strength to face each day ahead. If you don't want to be called a sinner, the church is the wrong place for you. If you want to build this thing on how far you can march, communion's going to seem awful silly when all we ask you to do is kneel. But here our Lord wants to give himself to those who don't have another step left in them. Here our Lord would give strength to the burdened, rest to the burdened, nourishment to you. When we are encouraging people to take the Lord's Supper, it's nothing other than help for everything that goes unspoken, because in the community of Christians, it's so hard to be known as the specific kind of sinner who actually needs help. But here, our Lord wants to be that help for you. Eat and drink the body and blood. There's forgiveness, there's life, there's salvation, there's rest. There's Jesus for you.